Hello, my name is Edie Hardin. I am from Wichita, Kansas, and I am a student at the University of Arkansas. The artwork I chose to research is located in the Crystal Bridges Museum of American Art in Bentonville, Arkansas. I chose the sculpture Sappho, which was created by William Wetmore Story in the late 19th century. William Wetmore Story studied at the University of Harvard, where he received both an undergraduate and a law degree. Story practiced law for approximately 5 years, but after his father's death in 1846, he abandoned law completely and dedicated his time and energy to studying sculpture. Story's work focused primarily on literary subjects. Some of his pieces include Cleopatra, The Angel of Grief, Le Bien Sibiel, and Medea. The Greek poet of love, Sappho, inspired this piece. Sappho was born on the island of Lesbos in 615 BC and was one of the most well-respected poets of her time. Sappho is known for her passionate poems about love and emotion. In the legend Story depicts, Sappho was said to have committed suicide after being rejected by her love, Phaon. In Story's sculpture, Sappho is sitting in a klismos chair, a type of chair from ancient Greece, contemplating her fate with a wilting rose, a symbol of failed love, drooping across her unstrung lyre. Story's Sappho stands roughly 5 feet tall and is around 3 feet wide. This sculpture was carved from a block of marble using the reduction process. Sappho can be viewed from all angles, making a three-dimensional sculpture in the round. The achromatic white hue creates a matte, polished texture that is pleasing to the eye. Simple geometric shapes make up Sappho's face, hair, breast, fingers, and toes. Her clothing consists of multiple diagonal, horizontal, and vertical lines, which help to create a very naturalistic appearance. The lines and shapes provide an immense amount of intricate detail to characteristics such as her hair and face, and to objects such as her clothing, necklace, and the chair. The arm resting on the chair causes the sculpture to rise vertically in a diagonal plane. Along with that, the slight bend of the torso causes an asymmetrical composition. The positioning of her body creates imbalance and disharmony. The iconographic method can be used to analyze Sappho. The iconographic method emphasizes the content of the work and implies that a written text underlies an image. In Story's Sappho, she is slightly bent at the torso, leaning against the arm of the klismos chair. She withholds an expressionless look upon her face and eyes gazing into the distance. Her facial expression suggests that she is contemplating a big decision. With help from the wilted rose drooped across the unstrung lyre, the observer is able to find the hidden symbolism and connect it to the legend of Sappho. A wilted rose is a symbol of failed love. Piecing together the wilted rose and her expression of deep thought, the observer is able to put two and two together to determine that Story is depicting the legend in which Sappho hurls herself off a cliff after being rejected by her love, Phaon. Recognizing the symbolic importance of this iconographic detail enriches our understanding of the work. Sappho was created in the 1800s, categorizing the sculpture into the Neoclassicism movement. Neoclassicism is the movement that emphasized a revival of decorative arts characterized by order, symmetry, and a simplicity of style. This movement returned to the calm grandeur of Greek sculptures with calm poses that were an upright, composed posture giving an overall feeling of stillness and poise. Story depicts this calm grandeur by placing his figures in relaxed, natural-looking positions with serene facial expressions that emphasize the calm stillness of the figures. Similar to many sculptures from the classical era, Sappho is an idealized depiction of the human body. She has a serene, expressionless look on her face. Her skin appears to be beautifully polished and without flaws. Each piece of hair is curled to perfection and is waved in a stylized manner. Unlike those features, her clothing falls in a very natural way. The way her dress hangs off her shoulder and bunches together on her lap emphasizes the worn, naturalistic texture of the cloth. Sappho's body position is very relaxed, causing her to lean to one side and rest on the arm of the chair. The positioning was inspired by the popular contrapposto stance that is often seen in standing sculptures from the classical era. Although she is slightly leaning, creating an imbalanced composition, her features remain proportionate. While her clothing and contrapposto-like positioning provide a more relaxed and naturalistic appearance, her perfect circular curls and the intricate detail of her necklace remain stylized. Also, her perky round breasts and delicately sculpted fingers and toes are without flaws, making those features idealized. This contrast between rigid and relaxed elements allows the viewer to feel the inner workings of the human body. I am in awe of how Story created a sculpture of such beauty and detail out of a block of marble. The way he managed to create a serene, expressionless face that at the same time shows Sappho in deep thought, contemplating her fate, amazes me. There is an immense amount of detail within Sappho, yet the sculpture holds a simplicity that is unexplainably beautiful.